The financial crisis, the pandemic, the current Russian attack on Ukraine, all these crises have one thing in common. They are all events that analysts estimated to have less than 0.007% chance of happening. That is, each of these events was expected to happen once every 50 years. How is it possible, then, that not one, but three of these crises occurred in just two decades? When analysts describe the most feared events in the market, they distinguish between three types of events: grey swans, black swans, and dragon kings. Let's take a look at each of them and try to understand what makes black swans so unpredictable and why they are considered to be true game changers. Imagine that you are given a coin, and you are asked to drop it trying to hit a target placed right below you, at your feet. You can throw as many coins as you want. If you keep track of where the coins hit the target each time, you would get a point distribution similar to this, with most of the coins clustered around the center of the target. Mathematically speaking, the coins are randomly scattered following a normal distribution. Now, remove the target, but leave the coins on the floor, and ask somebody to guess where the target was located by looking only at the coin distribution. Well, when you make economic predictions, you're basically doing the same thing. That is, you are trying to reconstruct an underlying pattern by looking only at a finite number of past observations. In this case, you can estimate the location of the target by simply calculating the center of mass of the coin distribution. Now, the bottom line in this experiment is that the more coins you dropped, the more accurate your estimate will be. That is, if you keep dropping more and more coins, the center of the distribution will tend to converge to the true center of the target. So, eventually, if you drop one more coin and recalculate the center of this new distribution, this will coincide more or less with the one that you calculated before. This is what in statistics is called law of large numbers. The law of large numbers comes from the fact that it is extremely unlikely that by mistake a coin could fall so far from the others to affect the average of the entire distribution. Such an extreme event is what we call a grey swan. A grey swan event is not only extreme, but also very unlikely, practically impossible. Now, most predictive models in economics and finance work more or less this way. We have a large number of observations. We assume that these observations are described by a normal distribution, and then we try to reconstruct the pattern behind them exactly as we try to reconstruct the position of the target. According to these models, events like a financial crisis or a pandemic outbreak are grey swans, and they are considered to be so unlikely that analysts essentially disqualify them as impossible, until they actually happen. This means that the normal distribution is not really representative of reality, so we need to define a new distribution. And this brings us to the definition of a black swan. Let's now do another experiment. Imagine this time that you want to hit the target not by dropping a coin on the floor, but by shooting a gun. Also in this case, if you shoot several times, most of the bullets will cluster around the center of the target. But there is a fundamental difference from the previous experiment. When shooting a gun, the bullets hit very distant part of the target surprisingly often. In fact, way more often than when dropping a coin. The reason for this is that when you shoot, small imprecisions in your hand position get amplified by the presence of a shooting angle. So, the probability of observing an event very far from the average is much higher than predicted by the normal distribution. In fact, the positions of bullets on a target are not described by a normal distribution, but by a so-called Cauchy distribution. Compared to the normal distribution, the Cauchy distribution has tails which are more pronounced, which means that the probability of extreme events is also much higher. Any outlier in this type of distribution is precisely what we call a black swan. A black swan event is extreme, but at the same time it occurs way more often than a grey swan. And this has a very interesting effect in our experiment. Even if you have fired already 1,000 shots, if you shoot one more time and then recalculate the center of the bullet's distribution, this new center will be different from the one calculated before. This is because black swans are so extreme and at the same time so frequent that they will keep changing the average of your observations. So we are dealing with a situation where the law of large numbers does not apply anymore, and guessing the location of the target from the shots fired up to a certain moment is virtually impossible. Now, it has been shown many times that macroeconomic events follow a Cauchy distribution. However, most of the models used by economists and financial institutions are still based on a normal distribution. Can you guess why? Well, the reason for this choice is actually, first of all, technical, because the normal distribution has some nice properties that make it extremely versatile and useful. Besides, if we accept to describe the world with a Cauchy distribution, then we would also need to accept that the law of large numbers does not work for financial events, which means that we could directly give up on making any kind of predictions. And this is something that scientists would definitely never really accept. And this brings us to the last type of event, the Dragon King. The person who came up with this name is a French physicist, Didier Sornet, who understood that some economic and financial events could not be described by a normal distribution. But he did not accept that these events could not be predicted. On this topic, I have already made an entire video that you can watch on this channel. But in short, if you look at the market curves before a market crash, like in the case of a financial crisis or the burst of a bubble, these curves show a very particular trend, where the number of oscillations tends to become more and more frequent before reaching the final crash. We call these events Dragon Kings. King because, like every monarch, they are true outliers. And dragon to highlight their almost mystical nature. In short, Dragon Kings are kind of black swans for which predictions can actually be made. And that's it for today. If you want to know more on how to predict financial markets and crashes, you can check out other videos on this channel. In the meanwhile, if you like this video, don't forget to support the channel by liking and subscribing. Thanks for watching.